There's one other aspect I just wanted to talk about here with these billet aluminium blocks. They have come through and become more popular, but we've seen them sort of really come out more from the drag racing world initially, and now we're starting to see them become adopted more and more for circuit racing. And there's a very big difference between what will work for a drag application where the car is only under high load for maybe 6 or 7 seconds, and then obviously you're talking about a circuit car that needs to be under high load for a minute 20, minute 30 in a row. The area I'm looking at here or interested in is the thermal expansion of the aluminium. It's obviously a lot higher than a cast iron block. So does this cause you any issues when you are choosing suitable bearing clearances, particularly for the main bearings?
Yeah, that is a major aspect to look into. And that, of course, needs to be taken into consideration, like what the power levels are and how much flex are you expecting in the crankshaft, because I mean, it's nice and straight when you have it on the table, but when it's running in the engine and you're really pushing it as hard as it can be pushed, it moves around by a significant amount. So you need to have enough clearance there so that you're not going to like start cutting the edges on the bearings. And beside that, you need to get enough mass flow through the bearing gaps to cool the bearings also. But In practice, you want to run a really small gap at room temperature because the crankshaft is an iron-based alloy that has a much lower thermal expansion rate than the block that is aluminum. So at around the same temperatures, the hole is going to get much larger than the pin inside it. So your bearing the clearances are going to increase quite significantly. So
I think there's a general trend when you're building performance engines to go with a clearance that is slightly looser than what would work for a factory engine, for exactly the reason you're saying. Obviously, everything does tend to flex and move at very high specific power and RPM levels. But of course, it is that trade-off as well. As those clearances get bigger, you also tend to lose oil pressure too. So sort of where's the trade-off on those two factors? Is oil pressure a problem? Have you seen issues with that with aluminium blocks as well?
Well, with the oil pressure, you only really need enough oil pressure to get the oil to the locations you need it to be. Then it's just a question of mass flow, basically. And one of the main things, you need to get the oil to the connecting rod pin, basically, from the main bearing. And depending on the type of drilling, you see a lot of OEM styles and a lot of aftermarket cranks also that have a just through drilled mains, basically. So you need to have enough oil pressure to push the oil all the way into the center of the crankshaft before it starts making its way out to the connecting rod bearing. And that's something that we've addressed. We have a sort of I think it's cross drilling. I'm not really sure what the correct term for that is, but we have angle drillings that go to connect those together and that are specifically angled and modified to not create high stress locations for that. But that helps a lot, so to sort of minimize the required oil pressure for that. Of course, then you end up having the oil squirters, which if you need to cool the pistons on the way up also to get more cooling capacity, then you again need to run quite a high oil pressure to get enough exit velocity from the nozzles. But there are, yeah, lots of things that need to be taken into consideration with that.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.